Well, our next guests know how to make a crowd go wild. In fact, the real thing, hitmaker Russell Morris, officially caused pandemonium when concertgoers came down with acute hysteria. Mm. And Rick Springfield needs no introduction except to say, Jesse's girl. Let's take a look at why we love them both so much.
It's probably our most spectacular production effort of the year. I know a lot of you thought it was made on film, but it's a studio effort. And I don't think they use more resources making Cleopatra. Russell Morris and the real thing.
And great news for us, the boys are back and they're making new music together. Rick and Russell join us now to tell us more. Rick, we'll start with you. After all these years, what does it feel like to look back at the songs that made you guys famous?
Well, I'm really bummed that Russell was the record and mine was the live version. That sucks!
I organized that, don't worry.
Yeah, a little side payment to the producers is all it takes for next time, Rick.
Oh, dude, I don't trust Russell Morris as far as I can throw him. I love Russell.
I'll tell you what, Rick still makes sends crowds into hysterics. I send them into hysterics for the wrong reasons these days. I scare the hell out of them.
Oh, you do not, Russell Morris. Listen to you. Hey, the real thing was just recently chosen to be part of the National Film and Sound Archive of Australia. That is a pretty big honour. Did you think it'd have the impact it has?
Fantastic. I'm officially a museum piece, am I?
Your self-deprecation knows no bounds.
No, it is nice. It's lovely. It's really nice to go down into that sort of history.
Fantastic. Rick, the much-anticipated Zoot reunion tour with Russell on vocals, it had to be postponed. Are there any plans to get it back on the road again?
Well, we're trying. You know, COVID keeps punching us in the face, but actually, you know what? Ask Beebe.
Mm. Yeah. You guys have been making music together since the 70s and we've got something new from you. You've just released Jack Chrome and the Darkness Waltz collaboration. We'll take a bit of a listen.
Look at
that
photo.
Shut up talking, it'll do no good. The devil's walking where God once stood. I tried to fathom the balance of power, but it all means shit in the final hour.
As we can probably tell from the makeup there in the clip, the album is a celebration of the Day of the Dead festival. What inspired the move into these haunting sounds?
Well, Russ started it. Why don't you tell him, Russ?
Hi. I loved the Day of the Dead festivals when I was in Los Angeles. I thought they were the most joyous occasions. I thought it's a beautiful sentiment to have a period of time, a week or 2 weeks, and bring back all the loved ones that you've lost and live with their souls and enjoy and feast and have parties and beautiful festivals. The festivals are so colourful, and it's not a dark, thing at all. It's a very beautiful thing. Yeah. And Rick and I did it in the persona of Jack Chrome. He is, we're the yin and yang of Jack Chrome. We're looking at life from the other side. We're talking as though we were dead. So we're sort of grateful we've been brought back to live with our loved ones.
Wow, that's super. You've talked about it being a friendly competition to write tracks for the album. Is it good, though, to have an accountability coach?
We're the accountability coach.
Yeah.
We
keep pushing each other. Yeah, we push each other to do. Yeah, there's accountability coaches. We had them when we were younger, but sometimes they work, sometimes they don't.
That's why we became musicians.
Yes, 100%. Rick, we're going to bring up a little something you said on our show when being interviewed by our good dear Craig Benesch. It was a bit of a promise you made. Take a listen to this.
So we got together and did a little bit of a concert, and people would tip, add more money and more money, and we keep saying, come on, we need, we need more and more. I actually offered to do the show naked if they'd get to 20,000, but we got to 11,000. Your fault.
So what cause can we get you behind so we can make sure this happens?
Dude, I am 72 years old. You don't want to see me naked.
I think... there we go. Promise delivered.
11 grand's
there
worth.
We go. That'll be thousands pouring in as we speak. It has been so good to catch up with you both. Jack Chrome and the Darkness Waltz, a 50-year dream collaboration, is out today. Rick Springfield and Russell Morris, it's been great to chat to you.
Thanks very much, Angela. Thanks, Tristan. Thanks, Ricky. Yeah. See you soon, mate.
Thanks, Russ. Give it a listen a couple of times. It won't grab you the very first time, but a couple of listens it will.
Good on you.
Love it. Thanks, guys.